Breaking news. Policemen in Southeast abandoned stations, uniforms, lobby for redeployment due to insecurity. Sahara Reporters learned that it is also increasingly difficult for the policemen to arrest suspects in neighborhoods or keep their suspects in the cell, as is the custom before cases are charged to court. Police officers deployed to the Southeast State in Imo State, Anambra, Abia, Ebonyi, and Enugu State are currently deserting their stations and now prefer to come in Mufti and few times they are at work without any work or pressure. Sahara Reporters learns that it is also increasingly difficult for the policemen to arrest suspects in neighborhood or keep their suspects in the cell, as is the custom before cases are charged to court. It was gathered that most policemen, particularly those who are not even indigents, are desperately seeking redeployment amidst fear of the incessant attacks by unknown gunmen. Sahara Reporters had on April 19 reported that most police officers in Abia were Mufti after heavily armed men attacked Izukoli police station in Bendel local government area in a string of other attacks on other stations. You can't find any police station open except those in the center of urban towns, which are close to other government offices and establishments. Such is the situation we have among us now. We can't police the rural areas. Our men are fleeing. It is expected because the situation is worsening and the federal might seems to have been weakened, a source said. According to Daily Post, with the absence of police officers from stations came the disappearance of checkpoints in the Southeast State, moving from Kanki in Enugu South local government area to Camp in Enugu North. The heading to the new market through trade fair complex in Transkulu in Nike Lake Hotel in Enugu local government area. All within the state capital, this happened, and there is no security checkpoint on any of the roads. This is unlike in the past when security checkpoints were mounted for stop and search exercises on motorists. The roads and streets of Enugu, the capital of Enugu State, are lacking on uniformed police officers and the usual security checkpoints. This is not unconnected with the ink in violent attack on security men and formation in the zone. It was also observed that police personnel no longer move about freely in their uniform. The fear of attack from unknown armed men is the beginning of wisdom, now said a few police officers. The same scenario was observed in Abia, the commercial hub of Abia State, as most checkpoints have been abandoned with no personnel to man them. A resident who does not want to be named said that, "I can confirm to you that there are no checkpoints in Abia again. The policemen have all asserted over the fear of possible killings by unknown gunmen. Policemen no longer patrol again. The military checkpoints are also deserted, especially in the evening." Meanwhile, residents of Aba have decried the rapid increase in the number of youths currently getting involved in cult-related activities. findings shows that some popular areas are now controlled by cultists who reign supreme with little or no confrontation from security operatives. Ogbo Hill is controlled by a group called Supreme Vikings, overrailed by Aro Baba Baga, Osioma, and Aye, Indigoru by Aro Baba Baga, while different cults control other areas. The police sergeant who first expressed fear talking to our correspondent said that security operatives are no longer safe in the state. Why are they killing and attacking us? We do this job with fear. We don't even know if we will return home alive after leaving the house in the morning. Most of the policemen killed have young children. Who will take care of them? He queried. I don't have the connection else. I would have moved my family out of here. I have to move my family out of Aba for fear of possible attacks, he added. Meanwhile, at least 7 policemen face an orderly room, their trial for deserting their duty post in Imo State. There are strong indications that police officers attached to the Imo State Police Command are currently seeking to be deployed out of state following a series of attacks on security personnel by suspected members of Eastern Security Network, the paramilitary wing of Indigenous People of Biafra. Some of the policemen are seeking help from both serving and retired senior police officers and their political godfathers. Investigation reveals that the officers seek to be deployed to investigating units such as the Special Fraud Units. The person of Inspector General of Police, Monitoring Units, and Special Squad, Abdul Karim Dadi. It was also learned that the affected personnel are currently meeting with their contracts within and outside the state and are willing to pay for their prayers to be granted. While some senior officers believe that the officers should remain in the state to tackle the insecurity problems, others have already reached out to the police high command to facilitate the deployment. Some of the officers who also based their request on the need to be reunited with members of their families. Thank you for listening to this news. You can imagine. Stupid set of people, lazy set of people, cowards. Imagine. Enough is enough. We are beginning to understand that every life matters. Since policemen are remembering that they have little ones left behind, that means it shows that they can never protect Nigeria again. So it's very obvious they are telling the federal government their mind. You can imagine. Since they said they left behind their little ones, if eventually they have been killed by unknown gunmen, at least this consciousness will assist in eliminating brutality and accidental discharge. So let's strengthen things for this point, from this point of view. Because the policemen have said it. It means they can no longer fight. You can imagine. They can no longer fight. My advice is don't transfer them. They should not be transferred. Let them stay 5-7 years in a station. Those days, policemen were 3 years, and for them to be corrupted with criminals who will later take advantage of the jurisdiction, then we are made to move on transfer. They are made to move on transfer. So for these days, once you're able to do a better return, then no leave, no transfer. Can you imagine? So as the criminals are tired of compulsory result or return, you have to come after them. You come after them in disguise. You can imagine, without them knowing the kind of person they are. Let them also face their plans and know how it feels. So viewers, your take concerning this news will be very much accepted. Please drop them below the comment box. Thank you.